Roll number 1.
Yes, ma'am.
2.
Present, ma'am.
3.
Present, ma'am.
4.
Present, ma'am.
5.
Present, ma'am.
6. Roll number 6.
Present, ma'am.
7. Roll number 7. 8.
Present, ma'am.
9.
Present, ma'am.
10.
Present, ma'am.
11.
Present, ma'am.
12.
Present, ma'am.
13.
Present, ma'am.
14. 14, roll number. 7. Roll number 14. Absent. Roll number 14, present or absent? 14 is absent. 15.
Present, ma'am.
16.
Present, ma'am.
17.
Present, ma'am.
18.
Present, ma'am.
19.
Present, ma'am.
20.
Present, ma'am.
21.
Present, ma'am.
22.
Present, ma'am.
23.
Present, ma'am.
24.
Present, ma'am.
25.
Present, ma'am.
26. 27.
Present, ma'am.
28. 27. Who is 27?
Present, ma'am. 27.
Vishnu Sharma.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. 28.
Present, ma'am.
29. Roll number 29. Absent. Roll number 29. 30.
Present, ma'am.
31.
Present, ma'am.
32.
Present, ma'am.
33.
Present, ma'am.
34.
Present, ma'am.
35.
Present, ma'am.
36.
Present, ma'am.
37. Roll number 37. Roll number 37, 38,
present, ma'am.
39,
present, ma'am.
40,
present, ma'am.
41,
yes, ma'am.
42, roll number 42, okay,
ma'am.
43,
present, ma'am.
44,
yes, ma'am.
45,
yes, ma'am.
Okay, so till now 3 students are absent, 14, 29 and 37. Initially it was showing that 44 students, but now it is showing 43 students. So 14, 29 and 37, these 3 students are absent. Okay, and fill up your Google form after my class. Thank you. why the total number of students are fluctuating. Now 43 is showing, initially it was showing 42, then after that 44. Now total strength is 44, it is showing. Now I'm just again announcing roll number 14, 29 and 37. Who is present here among these three? Roll number 14, 29 and 37. Total strength is showing 44. Who is present among these roll numbers? 14, 29 and 37. Now again 45. Now they're showing roll number 14, present. Roll number 29. Roll number 37. Am I audible? Students, am I audible?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. See, total strength is showing 45. Now it is 44. And just I'm announcing the roll numbers 14, 29 and 37. So initially when I call by roll numbers, then they have not given their attendance 14, 29 and 37. But are they present here now? Otherwise, I will make you absent. Is the screen visible?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Roll number 8, what is your name? Roll number 8, what is your name?
I'm Aditya.
So you were absent in my last class yesterday?
Yes, I was unable to join due to network problem.
Due to network problem? Where do you live?
Yes, ma'am. I'm Durgapur.
Where are you staying now?
I'm in Durgapur only.
Durgapur?
Yes, ma'am.
So I have sent you the note. I have sent you the all the notes. So go through it. Because yesterday's class was very much important. Now what I discussed yesterday, I discussed force vibration, the starting of force vibration, and the difference between damped and force vibration. That is, if external periodic force is applied to the system to make up the losses, the amplitude of vibration does not decrease with time and the body vibrates regularly under such periodic force. And this type of vibration is called the force vibration. In damped harmonic, damped oscillatory motion, what happens? The amplitude of vibration that
gradually decreases.
That decreases with time. And for what? Due to the loss of energy to overcome the resistive force. But in force vibration, as we are supplying external periodic force and it is supplied to the system to make up those losses, so amplitude of vibration does not decrease with time and the body will vibrate regularly under such periodic force. And this type of vibration is known as force vibration that I discussed. I discussed the differential equation. What will be the differential equation of fourth vibration? This is m d2x by dt square equal to minus x equal to minus x minus b into dx by dt plus f0 e to the power ipt. So this is the extra term, f0 e to the power ipt, that is in the differential equation of fourth vibration. And starting from this equation, we have solved this equation number one, and we have find out the solution, and the solution was, and the total solution, that was x equal to c into d to the power minus kt, then sine of omega dash t plus delta. And this term, you know, this is the solution we calculated earlier for damped oscillatory motion. And the second part is this. This is small f by root over this term into e to the power I pt minus 5. So this is a term due to the forced vibration. So first part is the solution, represents first part in equation number 11. So what is the first part? C into e to the power minus kt sine of omega dash t plus delta. So this part of the solution represents damped simple harmonic motion. And after a few time, vibration becomes negligible as its amplitude diminishes exponentially with time. So this is the amplitude diminishes exponentially with time, and it is, we can say it from the first part, that is C into the power minus kt. So this is the amplitude part, and you can see the amplitude diminishes exponentially with time because the term e to the power minus kt is there. So that is amplitude diminishes exponentially with time. And after a lapse of time, the second part means this part of equation 11, so this is the steady state term, represents the forced sustained oscillation. So this term, second part, represents the forced sustained oscillation whose frequency is p by 2 pi will be the frequency of the applied force. And here, so the solution of forced vibration, so we can write it as x equal to this term, that is f by root over this into d to the power I pt minus 5. So it is equation number 12. Now what is the amplitude? The first part is the amplitude. So first part of the amplitude is, so the first part is amplitude, and what is the amplitude? A equal to small f by root over 4 k square p square plus omega square minus p square whole square. So giving it equation number 13. So frequency is p by 2 pi, and what is the phase? Phase is phi. So e to the power I pt minus phi is there. So phi is the phase, and it is given by tan inverse inside the bracket 2 kp by omega square minus p square. So it is equation number 14. Now I'm just repeating all these things, all the things I have discussed yesterday, as there were two classes yesterday, so I discussed a lot. So for that reason I'm just repeating this. So the physical solution can be extracted from the complex solution. So actually this is the complex solution, so e to the power I pt minus phi is there. So physical solution we can extract from the complex solution by taking the real and imaginary part respectively. So if we take the real and imaginary part of this term, then we can find out the physical solutions. Now when the driving force is f0 sine omega t, so the force is, if we take the force as f0 sine omega t, the steady state solution of the force vibration will be, so this is one solution, equation number 12 is solution. But if I want to write it physically, then the driving force, if we consider that f0 sine of omega t, the steady state solution of the forced vibration, it is given as what? X equal to f by this term. So this is as it is, it remains. And this term, initially there was e to the power I pt minus 5. Now I'm writing it as sine of pt minus 5. So as I'm taking the driving force as f0 sine of omega t, physically we are writing the solution. So x equal to f by root over this thing into sine pt minus 5. So in the same way, you can write what is f, small f I have written. So this is f0 by m, and I have discussed it earlier. And x equal to what? A sine pt minus 5. So this is the expression. So a is what? The first part is the a, that is amplitude. Amplitude is what? Small f by root over 4 k square p square plus omega square minus p square whole square into sine pt minus 5. So x equal to a sine pt minus 5. Now we can find out dx by dt. So if I find out dx by dt, then differentiate it. So differentiate it with respect to t. Then here it is sine pt minus 5. So p is we are getting when you're differentiating this term. So ap cos of pt minus 5, sine pt minus 5 is changing to cos pt minus 5. So dx dt velocity, we have this. Now we know that is dx dt is velocity. Now again I can represent it this, and dx dt means a into p into cos of vt minus phi. So dx dt is velocity, so in place of left hand side I am writing v, and in place of writing in place of right hand side, what is right hand side? Right hand side is a p cos pt minus phi. So I am writing this cos pt minus phi like this. Can I write this?
Yes, ma'am.
Cos of pt minus phi, I am writing here as sine of pt minus phi plus pi by 2. You know, sine of pi by 2 plus that angle, it can be converted to cos. So I can write this as cos of pt minus phi equal to what? Sine of pt minus phi plus pi by 2. So x, so here x equal to a sine pt minus phi, and velocity, it can be written as in terms of sine. Actually the velocity is calculated when it is we are getting in terms of cos. So if I want to write in terms of sine, then we have to write the velocity in this way. Now it is written here. So in the steady state condition, the velocity of the driven oscillator at an instant of time leads the displacement by 90 degree. So here it is pt minus phi, but here it is pt minus phi plus phi by 2. So the velocity, so the steady state solute condition, the velocity of the driven oscillator at an instant of time leads the displacement by 90 degree. So it can be proved from this. So the steady state condition, the velocity of the driven oscillator at an instant of time leads the displacement by 90 degrees. So we have the expression of displacement from here, x equal to a sine pt minus phi, and the velocity equal to ap sine pt minus phi plus pi by 2. So we can conclude this. The steady state condition, the velocity of the driven oscillator at an instant of time leads the displacement by 90 degrees. So here we are getting pi by 2 term. So I'm writing it as 90 degrees. So up to this, we have discussed about force vibration. As I have said, that what is force vibration, the questions, and what is the difference between damped vibration and force vibration? What is the differential equation of force vibration? So this is the differential equation of force vibration. Then the solution, we have calculated, we have estimated the solution of this differential equation, and we have the solution like this, equation number 11. And first part is represents the damped simple harmonic motion, and the second part that represents the force sustained oscillation whose frequency p by 2 pi will be the frequency of the applied force, and this is the solution of the force vibration. This is x equal to small f by this term into to the power I pt minus phi. First part is amplitude, and phase is given by this, phi equal to this. And if we want to write it physically, then the driving force I'm taking as F0 sine omega t, and the same thing I'm writing in place of e to the power term. So sine of pt minus phi you are getting with this amplitude part. So displacement equal to amplitude into sine pt minus phi. We have also calculated the velocity, and velocity we can write it as ap sine pt minus phi plus phi by 2. So we can say the conclusion, so it is pi by 2 plus term is here. Here it is pt minus phi, here it is pt minus phi plus pi by 2. So that is the, we can say that the driven oscillator at an instant time, so the steady state condition, the velocity of the driven oscillator at an instant of time leads the displacement by 90 degree. So that was the yesterday's class. I have completed it today because half portion I discussed yesterday. Now this part is completed. Now I'm going to my next presentation. Just wait. Now in the second part, this is the second part of force vibration and second lecture, that is the amplitude resonance and velocity resonance. Now amplitude resonance, when the displacement amplitude of the force vibration is maximum for a particular frequency, that is resonance frequency of the applied force, of the applied periodic force, the phenomena is called the amplitude resonance. And already you know the force in force vibration, the displacement is given by x equal to a e to the power I pt minus phi. So there a, that term, that is the amplitude. So amplitude of force vibration, it is written here separately. A is small f by root over this term, that is 4 k square p square plus omega square minus p square whole square. So giving it equation number 15, it is the continuation of the previous lecture. So I have given it equation number 15. Now amplitude varies with the frequency of the applied force, and A is maximum for a particular value of P for which the denominator is minimum. So when A is maximum, the value of A is maximum when the denominator is minimum, and for a particular value, and for a particular value of P for which the denominator is minimum. The frequency of the applied force, and when the denominator is minimum, the amplitude becomes maximum, and A is maximum for a particular value of P for which the denominator is minimum. Now what we are taking, let suppose that FP equal to 4 k square p square plus omega square minus p square whole square. So what I am taking here, I am taking this 4 k square p square plus omega square minus p square whole square, that I am taking as FP. Let now if we differentiate this and if we write ddp of FP, then that is equal to zero. Now just it is mathematical calculation is done here. So if it is minimum, this denominator will be minimum if the amplitude is maximum. Now for this the condition is ddp of FP equal to zero. Now just differentiate this ddp of FP. I have written the value of FP here and I have differentiated this term. So after mathematical calculation, simple calculation, I'm getting minus 4 into P, and inside the bracket omega square minus P square minus 2 of K square, bracket close, equal to zero. So either this term can be zero or this term can be zero, but P, that can't be zero here. So what may be zero? So what may be zero? The bracketed term is zero. So the bracketed term is zero. Now if the bracketed term is zero, then what I can write? Omega square minus P square minus 2K square equal to zero. So if this term is zero, then the value of omega square minus P square, that is equal to 2K square. So that I have written, that omega square minus P square equal to 2 into K square. So ultimately we are going to find out the value of P from here. So P square equal to omega square minus 2K square. So from here getting the value of P. P is what? P is root over omega square minus 2K square. And I am taking it as PR, say, and giving it equation number 16. So this is the equation number 16. Now this is the condition. Provided omega square greater than 2K square. So P is root over omega square minus 2K square. So omega square, it is greater than 2K square. Otherwise, you will get negative term, negative sign here, and negative of root you will get. So provided we have written this, that is omega square is greater than 2K square. So from here, FR we can calculate. FR is root over omega square minus 2K square by 2 pi. So this is the value of FR, frequency. So this is PR actually. PR is root over omega square minus 2K square. So if I divide this by 2 pi, getting the value of FR, at which A is A max. So for this, A is A max. And it has been observed that D2FP by DP square is greater than 0. So FP is minimum. So actually our assumption was, actually we want to prove that the what will be the maximum value of the amplitude, for what, for which condition the amplitude has maximum value. So for that denominator we have to prove minimum denominator part. So this part will be minimum if A is maximum. So if the denominator is minimum, then we can write denominator term I am taking like this, not root over I have taken, only FP I have taken without root over this term. So if it is minimum, then DDP of FP we can write zero. And also the condition will satisfy if you differentiate this two times, that is if you find out D2FP by DP square, you will get greater than zero value. So FP is minimum. Now it is the condition, if you find out D2FP by DP square, you will get greater than zero value. So you will get FP as minimum. So FP is minimum, this is proved here. If you differentiate this twice, now we can apply this condition, DDP of FP equal to zero. So DDP of FP we have written zero, and for this zero value, I have calculated the value of P. So P is given by root over omega square minus k square, and the frequency is given as root over omega square minus 2k square by 2 pi. So divided by 2 pi. So here root over omega square minus 2k square is less than both natural angular frequency omega for undamped motion and the frequency omega square minus k square or omega dash in presence of damping. So for amplitude resonance, that means A is A max. What is the frequency? Frequency is given by root over omega square minus 2k square by 2 pi. Now, A max is what? A max that we have to find out. Actually, this is the initial expression, that F by root over 4k square p square plus omega square minus p square whole square. Now, what I will do? I will replace the value of P. I will replace the value of P. And the value is given as root over omega square minus 2k square. So that value I will replace. Now see, p square equal to that value, it is replaced here. This is omega square minus p square. So it is omega square term, then minus of p square it is written, then whole square. And here it is 4k square. It is written as it is. And with that p square value, it is written here. So whatever value of p we have calculated, so replacing the value of P in the expression of amplitude, then ultimately getting after calculation, just simple calculation, mathematical calculation, this is A max equal to small f by 2k into omega square minus k square. Now I can write again what I have done. I have here minus k square, it is written as minus 2k square plus k square. So minus 2k square plus k square is minus k square, so it is written as it is. So mathematically just simple I have written this, and this is equal to small f by 2k, then omega square minus 2k square. What is this? Omega square root over omega square minus 2k square, that is p square. So in this place omega square minus 2k square I have written p square. So ultimately we have concluded the expression, what will be the value of a max equal to small f by 2k into root over p square plus k square, and this is the equation number 17. Now amplitude of oscillation, so A is the amplitude of oscillation and this is the value of A max. The amplitude of oscillation actually depends upon the damping factor, so it depends upon the value of k. You can see from this equation, so amplitude depends on the value of k. Now here, if in this equation if I put k equal to zero, what I'm saying that amplitude of oscillation depends upon the damping factor k. Now at what I'm doing here, equation number 17, putting the value of p equal to zero. So if I put p equal to zero, f max, what is the value? P equal to zero. So root over of k square means k. So 2k square. So small f by 2k square. So yeah, if p equal to zero, then a max becomes f by 2k square. And P equal to again, and P equal to again root over omega square minus 2k square, and if P equal to 0, then from here we can write omega square equal to 2k square. So maximum amplitude is greater for lower value of damping factor k except p equal to omega. So maximum amplitude is great, maximum amplitude, that is amplitude is greater for lower value of damping factor k. So come here. So a has maximum value, the value of a will increase if the value of k is decreasing. If the value of k is decreasing, the value of amplitude will increase. So k decreases, amplitude increases. So come to this graph. Say k equal to zero means no damping. Is this graph visible?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so k equal to zero, that is no damping. This is the case light damping, k small. This is k medium, and this is heavy damping, that is k large. So different k values are shown. This is the graph of amplitude versus frequency. And you can see from here, if the value of k increases, so for heavy damping, the value of k is large, and for light damping, the value of k is small. So you can see this is the amplitude. Amplitude is plotted along the y-axis. So this one, so this is the amplitude here. So it is here, it is amplitude. For a light damping case, this is the value of amplitude. So it is the value of amplitude. For medium damping, this is the value of amplitude. And for heavy damping, this is the value of amplitude. This is the value of amplitude for heavy damping. So you can say k large, amplitude less. K medium, so amplitude increases. K small, amplitude increases more. So amplitude increases with the when k decreases. So amplitude, you can see here amplitude is larger. So amplitude increases when k decreases. Is it clear from this graph?
Yes.
So from this expression, so this is a max equal to root over equal to f by 2k into root over p square plus k square. So k is larger, a value is smaller. K is smaller, a value larger. So this is proved from that graph. Now for low damping, when p equal to omega, then what happens? For low damping, when p equal to omega, then a max equal to f by 2kp. So when for low damping, when p equal to omega, then what happens? Come here. Come to this expression. A max equal to f by root over 4 k square p square plus omega square minus p square whole square. Okay. So here, put the value of omega equal to p. What value of a max you are getting? At omega equal to p, what is the value of a max? In this expression,
f by 2kp omega.
F by
2kp.
F by what?
F by 2kp.
Okay. So when omega equal to p, getting a max as f by 2kp. I have written this thing. Okay. A max equal to what? F by 2kp. And when? And tan phi, this expression you already know. I have proved this. Have I? Tan phi? From
yes,
the previous question?
Yes, ma'am.
Tan phi. That is 2kp by omega square minus p square. So 2kp by omega square minus p square. So if here p equal to omega, then what will happen? It is written here. phi equal to what? Tan phi expression I have, if p equal to omega, what is phi? Tan inverse 2kp by k is 0 na? What? Omega equal to p. So tan phi equal to what? 2kp by 0, is it?
Yes, ma'am.
So phi equal to what? Tan inverse of?
Phi by 2.
2kp by 0? And 1 by 0 equal to what?
Infinity.
So I have written this term. And this is equal to what? Pi by 2. So here phi equal to what? Pi by 2. So you can calculate in this way the phase. Now, when k equal to 0, k 0 means what? It is undamped motion. K equal to means 0 means there is no damping. This is undamped motion. And when the k of a k value will increase, the amplitude will decrease. K value will increase, the amplitude will decrease. Now, when k equal to 0 at p equal to omega, the amplitude of oscillation is very large and theoretically infinite. So when k equal to 0 and p equal to omega, see, what is this case? F max. What is the value of F A max? F by 2kp. What is the value of A max? F by 2kp. In which condition? At p equal to omega, is it? At p equal to omega, what is the value of amplitude? Maximum? F by 2kp. F by 2kp. A max equal to F by 2kp. When? At p equal to omega. Now, if I put k equal to 0 here, then what will happen? K equal to 0, there is no damping. If I put in this expression k equal to 0, then what is the value of A max? If in this expression, if I put the value of k equal to 0, then what is the value of mx?
Infinity.
Why anyone not answering? It is clear from the equation. If in this expression,
Bye-bye, ma'am. Same as etiquette.
खत्म हो गया क्या भाई लोग?
हाँ खत्म हो गया, गुड बाय। इसीलिए मैं पहले ही लीव कर
बच्चे।
There was one issue of internet connection. Hello, now am I audible, students?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Now what I'm what I was discussing, I was discussing this slide. Now screen is visible?
Yes, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am, not visible.
Not
no,
visible.
Ma'am, not visible.
Not visible.
Okay. Wait. Now is it visible?
Yes, ma'am.
Today is very problem with the internet connection. So A max is equal to A by 2kp. That I have proved. Okay. And when p equal to omega. Now for undamped motion, what is the value of k? K is zero.
Zero.
If I put the value of k here as zero, then what I will get?
Infinity.
So amplitude becomes infinity. So here come to the this graph. So no damping case, k equal to what? Zero. No damping means undamped motion. What is the value of k here showing in the graph? K is
zero.
Infinity, we can't touch it in this line. Okay, so you can see it is going upwards and it will touch at infinity. So amplitude is along the y-axis and this curve, it is drawn like this. Clear for you all? So at here for k small, say it is touching here in this, so you are getting the peak. You are getting the peak, and you can say from here, if you draw a line in this direction, then you will get, when it touches, you will get the value of amplitude. But here at k equal to zero, what is happening? It is touching at where? Y-axis along here, infinity. It is going infinity. So you can see amplitude is going infinity when there is no damping. So for every damping, that is k small, k medium, k large, you can get this type of peak, and you are getting the value of amplitude here, getting the value. But where? For no damping case, for k equal to zero, it amplitude will be infinity. You can say here, what is the value of amplitude for this curve, for this curve, for this curve, what is the value of amplitude? You can say. But for this curve, when k equal to zero, you can't say anything. What will be the value? Because the amplitude becomes infinite. So at k equal to zero. So I'm getting it from this. So at p equal to omega, what is the case? For low damping case, p equal to omega. For p equal to omega, Amx, the value is given as f by 2kp. And from where? We have this. Amx equal to this. Now p equal to omega, we are getting the expression f by 2kp. Now only I have written this thing, Amx equal to f by 2kp. Now when k equal to zero, then you are getting A, as amplitude of oscillation is very large. And theoretically, so remember this, theoretically it is infinite. Amplitude of oscillation is very, very large, and theoretically it is infinite. And the displacement lags behind the applied voltage by pi by 2. So displacement lags behind the applied voltage by pi by 2. So this is our conclusion. And it is clear from this graph. So here in this graph, amplitude is plotted with frequency. This is p equal to omega, and this side is p greater than omega, and this side is p less than omega. And this is the sharpness of resonance. Actually, this is called sharpness of resonance. You can see this is the sharp resonance, and this is the flat resonance. I will discuss in my next class. Actually, today time is almost over. It is 10:57. So I'm not discussing this thing, but whatever I have discussed in this class, you can conclude that for small damping case, amplitude is larger, and for high damping case, amplitude is lower. And for no damping case, that is for k equal to zero, amplitude becomes theoretically infinite. That means amplitude is very, very large. So that we can conclude from here. So what I have done today, amplitude, this is the form of amplitude. Now when A is maximum, we have to find out. So for this reason, we are taking the denominator is minimum. Now this value I am taking, that fp equal to this. Now if I find out d2 fp by dp square, we will get it is giving greater than zero. So fp is minimum. Now from here I have calculated ddp of fp equal to zero. Do you know these things mathematically? When the one function is maximum or minimum, mathematically you should
ma'am.
You know
ma'am, 2 minute baki hai class attend karne mein.
Ma'am 11 baje se math class hai.
Next class you have na?
Yes ma'am.
Okay, so I am leaving this class and next thing I will discuss tomorrow. Okay.
Okay ma'am.
Okay. Send the notes ma'am.
Okay, I will send the notes. I will send the notes.
Thank you ma'am.
Okay, so leaving the class.
Thank you ma'am.
Okay.